Chris Masters, who's back, who will probably be gone again real soon.
Oh, yeah. He'll test ready.
Versus Swack Jagger.
Right.
And no Eagle.
He's Eagle-less.
That's right.
I had to say that. Sorry.
That's a Survivor Series preview match. Kind of interesting. They didn't really understand how they kind of did this Survivor Series run-up. It's kind of like right. They gave us Survivor Series. But
you know, I love the energy. Mm-hmm. It was very excellent back-and-forth wrestling. Back
okay,
and
good.
Forth.
Seesaw.
Yeah, it was. But Swagger ends up trying to rip Master's knee out. You know?
Yeah.
That was pretty brutal.
Yeah, I know. I did see that. And we got two guys here who are submission experts going against each other. Hey, here's an idea. Make it a submission match.
What? Well, that's pretty revolutionary.
The Ankle Lock versus the Master Lock.
Hey, Karis, can I ask you something?
Call it the Lockout.
Oh, the Lockout. I didn't mean to. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Why is it wrestlers could always counter out of Kurt Angle's Ankle Lock back in the day? You know how every match you'd have at least two or three kick outs of his Ankle Lock, but no one can kick out of Jack's Ankle Lock. And you know why? This sounds weird, because Kurt was a better wrestler. I know that doesn't make sense.
No, it actually, it makes perfect sense. I like it. You know, I have some notes on this.
Go for it.
Greatest reversal of the Master Lock I've ever seen. When he jumped over the ropes.
Oh, yes. That was,
I have never seen a reversal like that.
That was groundbreaking.
You know, and Swagger gets some love out of that. Swagger targets the ankle on the corner post and then picks up the win. But two guys with submission finishers was great. Now, here's how Angle would have done the end of that match. It would have gone reversal, 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 tap.
Actually, Angle would have done the lay down ankle lock. You know,
the grapevine. And then he would have done the grapevine at the end.
Right, exactly.
Okay, but Angle didn't even do the grapevine for a long time.
Not near the end.
But Swagger, you're right. He's not as good of a wrestler. He is taller, but it doesn't. No. It just doesn't look like he's putting the same pressure on. It definitely doesn't look like what we're used to with
Kurt
Angle.
It seems the way he has the ankle so high up, all you do is just flip around once and kick him with your other leg and get out of it.
Yeah.
I mean, Mysterio did that all the time with Kurt Angle.
Well, Mysterio is a legend.
He certainly is.
Okay, dodgeball with Edge was kind of funny.
That was, especially the shot on goal he scores. Boom.
Okay, next match. Turned out to be slightly depressing, very exciting. Caval versus Dolph with Vicky, who choked out Mark Henry last week, did Dolph. Very impressive, so we figure he's on a roll, right? And first of all, Caval gets called out for his internet fan base.
Right, which is, I think, what a hater that guy is.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong with the internet fan base?
Sorry, he has a fan base. You don't cry me a river.
Dolph Perfect is just a jackass.
I mean.
But Matt Stryker had the best saying of the whole night. He was talking about Vicky. He said, Vicky dressed up in purple looks like Barney. I had to write that down. It was golden. Then Dolph starts running his mouth like he usually does, you know, which usually equates to nothing.
Yeah, and this time he actually has to eat his words.
Mm-hmm.
Because Dolph loses the match to a really interesting pin combination. And
Caval
picks up the win. Very good job, Cavalki.
All I can say is, what a great match. And I mean that. I mean, if you blink, you might miss something. That's how brilliant this match was. Caval had the great counter to the zigzag. That was perfect, too. You can cover that. And Loki deserved the win. He deserved the win.
He did. Now, here's the part that depressed me. He got up. He got onto the announce table. He put his hands up. And Cole said, like he won the Super Bowl. He must have watched our TNA review, because I went off on Jay Lethal about that. And I just wasn't happy with Caval's promo. He could have got the crowd a lot more. He could have been a lot angrier or live. He's a very interesting technico.
Yeah, but he needs more fire. I want to see a little more emotion out of him.
Yeah, right now he's Thunderbolt.
I mean, he sounds like a bad voiceover. No, it's like it's not his real voice. I'm serious.
It's like he got dubbed in.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it sounds like.
Okay, next match. Women's match. Now, this match was about a minute and a half long. And Natalya Neidhart will be fighting Lay Cool at the pay-per-view for the belts. She could pull a Matt Morgan. It'd be great. We could call her Natalya and Neidhart. We just call them. You know what? Let's just call Natalya the Hart Dynasty. Because to be honest with you, not even Tyson Kidd can wrestle as good as Natty. It's true.
And you know,
but it didn't go that long. But it was on point. It was clean. It was quick. It finished right. It was a good match. You know, if you just drag that out in 8 minutes, you got yourself a women's division.
You know, women's wrestling is one thing, but Natalya Neidhart, she's completely different. Yeah. I'm still pushing for, I think that she's not only going to win that 2-on-1 handicap match at Survivor Series, I think after that she should start wrestling men.
Yeah.
Challenge it. Look at that.
You went over this last week, too. You wanted to challenge for the
title. I'm on a bandwagon. You know, as far as I'm concerned, the IC title's up for grabs now.
Yeah.
Caval's got it now.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, no, he's going to.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, obviously.
And she's deserving. I think she should throw her hat in the ring.
I agree. We get to the next match.
Well, actually, you know what? We're talking about, I was talking about the Rock promo. You know that movie? I don't know.
Faster or something like that. What didn't catch me the way a Rock movie usually does, even the promos.
Yeah, but it just looks so cliche. I'm sorry. I mean, I'm not a film director.
No, maybe it'll be a good movie because we're all Rock fans. We're all going to watch the movie at some point on Hulu or Netflix Showtime or DVD or in the movies.
Well, if he's going to do another movie, I'd like to see him do the Game Plan 2 or something.
The Game Plan 2 would be great. Just got to get another girl
Race
and have her
Switch
be the
Mountain
same
Part
age.
3, something like that. Oh, they didn't do Part 2 yet. Never mind.
Maybe she could buy it. It'd be like Race to the Rundown. Okay, what do we got next?
No. Well, let's go back. Let's go back to match number 4, Kofi versus Cody.
Cody's best match ever. And we only got about a minute and a half left.
And I call Cody the new age narcissist. How do you like that? The new age narcissist.
Cody impressed. Cody looks like a real wrestler. Holy crap.
You know, I tried to watch this match, and my mind started wandering. I started thinking about the Kane promos with Edge and Paul.
Yeah.
You know, they're just so ingrained in my mind. I've seen it so many times. But then the match picked up, and it did have a great ending.
Yeah.
You know, it did pick up. It was really good.
Cody did a really good job. I'm very happy. The main event was kind of changed up a little bit here. We got to get through this.
Show Tyler Rex.
Show versus T-Rex.
Mm-hmm.
And that was over really quick.
I got one note.
And then it ended up being Del Rio versus 619. No, wait, it's 10-man battle royal.
Show. Show was so retarded, he has to put his first name on the front of his shirt, you know.
Knucklehead.
Leads us to the last part of the show here.
Oh, yeah, the 10-man. Del Rio versus 619 was actually the main event.
Right.
But they're not going to give us that for free, but they're going to give us all the Survivor Series for free.
It was Lucha at its best, but it turns out it was just a teaser match.
Del Rio versus Mysterio.
I knew it was too good to be true. At least we got one move out of it.
Definitely. And then, of course, Rey and Show prevail, and it was a really good show.
You know, Big Show's a technician in the ring. I mean, where did he train at the dungeon? I mean, he was amazing to me with his headbutts and slaps to the chest. His kicks couldn't break wind, though. I got a fun fact.
We don't have any time. We'll have to catch that next week.
Okay.
So people tune in next week for another fun fact from King Fred. My name is Hebrew Heat. This is the Adult Demographic. Give us the greatest tagline in the business.
King Fred out.
Now do it again with the other hand.
King Fred.